is rice or noodles better? Watch on to the end, because in this video, we are going to do a very objective comparison based on science, statistics, and surveys using a point system. So the results will be completely impartial. So, before anything, this isn't just a video of me giving my opinions or me interviewing people on the street. It's also not a tier list. Instead, what I'm going to do is to assess based on hard figures and then giving the winner a point based solely on the number. For example, if the nutrients in one food are better based on a specific key point, like you know the amount of protein it has, then it gets 1 point. So on and on. It's not just about nutrients, though that falls under science, but you get the idea. So eventually, whichever has the highest number of points win. Like what I mentioned earlier, you'll comprise comparison based on science, statistics, and surveys. Now, before I start, let me add a disclaimer in case Health Minister Ong Yee Kang is watching this, because I'm scared of him. He knows Taekwondo, he's a TikTok star, I'm scared. If you have to choose between white rice and noodles, choose the third option. Nothing. You see, both rice and noodles are simple carbs, which means they are unhealthy. You can survive without them in all your meals. But then again, you remember this. Does that mean that this is wrong? Yeah, you bodo, you didn't watch my previous video. You see, this ceramic food chart was first created back in 1974 in Ikea. Sweden, but got popular in the US in 1992. And as you all know, whatever is popular in the US, you'll be popular everywhere. It showed that we need to eat lots of rice or noodles or bread, up to 11 servings, depending on what ceramic you see. But here's the thing, this was created back in Sweden because food prices were high, so they had to have this idea of having cheap basic food. And of course, that means having more rice or noodles or bread, since they're cheap and are basic like you ma. There are other countries also started using it, but remember, back in the days, the key is to stay alive, not to stay healthy. I mean, stay healthy is also important, but anyways. Because remember, in the past, having enough food on the table is already a problem by itself. Also, there were accusations that certain food companies lobby for this, so we will buy more rice, noodles, and breads. But anyways. Eventually, that will slowly change with this first, and then finally, this. Similarly, in Singapore, we are now using this. And you realize that there's no white rice or noodles. So long story cut short, contrary to what your father said, you don't need rice, noodles, or bread to survive. Now, brown rice is fine, but here's a problem. Some hawkers and restaurants actually mix lots of white rice with brown rice and still call it brown rice. So you might be misled into thinking that you're eating brown rice when you're actually having more white rice. Therefore, I would suggest that you either cook your own brown rice at home or avoid them altogether in eateries. Now, with the health disclaimer out of the way, let's move on to the battle between rice and noodles. We have to be very specific in our choice so that this comparison will be accurate. For rice, it'll be purely cooked white rice. For noodles, it's going to be a bit tricky because what noodles should we use? Should it be mee pok, mee kia, or what's this called again?
Semian.
English la, bodo.
Noodles.
Oh. Yeah, because all other noodles have names except for this, which is technically called yellow noodles or egg noodles in English, but we all usually just call it noodles. We'll just use this for our comparison. Note that we are using the noodles that's the OG version, not those wholemeal version. Now, let's begin. First of all, we are going to compare based on science. This means these are hard facts that cannot be changed even after thousands of years. Just like how science won't change after thousands of years ma. It's not that many years ago, we all thought that the world is made out of fire, water, earth and air right? Really? For science, it's mainly the nutrients, but there might be some other factors. We are going to use 100 grams for both rice and noodles, but do note that usually, we eat more than 100 grams of rice or noodles. Also, we are looking at cooked rice and noodles. Different types of rice and noodles might have different figures, so note that this is just a rough estimate and don't cast these figures to stone lah. Firstly, it's of course calories, which needs no explanation. The fewer the calories, the better it is. For 100 grams of rice, there are about 130 calories. For 100 grams of noodles, there are about 138 to 178 calories. Later, I'll explain why the calories for noodles can be so broad. So in this case, there's a clear winner, rice. Now, here's the thing. Calories might be important, but it's actually not as important as the glycemic slope, which is called the GL. Basically, we just need to know this. The higher the GL, the worse it is, as it will spike up your blood sugar, and excess blood sugar will be converted into fats. If the GL is low, you'll be digested slower, so your blood sugar will spike up, and therefore, there might not be excess sugar for your body to convert them into fats, as the sugar is distributed evenly. So, for rice, the GL is about 26. For noodles, the GL is about 19. Now, note that GL requires some calculation and some variations, so this is a very rough figure. Nevertheless, as you know, the lower the GL, the better it is. So, noodles is the clear winner here. Next is protein. You see, protein are kind of like a super nutrient that we need. Not only can it help to build our muscles, they'll keep us full longer too. And our body is actually built to look for protein, which can be used for energy if needed. Therefore, the more protein a food has, the better it is. For 100 grams of rice, there's 2.7 grams of protein. For 100 grams of noodles, there's about 4.5 grams of protein. Moreover, noodles proteins are generally better because it's kind of from eggs. So there's a clear winner here, it's noodles. Now, next, there's fiber. Once again, fiber is a super nutrient that's super underrated. I've done a video to explain why fiber is extremely important for both your body and your mind, and heck, even your immune system. But long story cut short, just don't think that fiber just helps in digestion, yo. It helps in everything, except that it will help you find a girlfriend, you user who's single forever. For 100 grams of rice, it has 0.4 grams of fiber. Yeah, very pathetic. For 100 grams of noodles, it has 1.2 grams of fiber. Both are very pathetic, which is why they are so unhealthy. But noodles is the lesser of two evils, so noodles win here. Finally, for science, we need to look at the worst thing of all, amount of processing. By now, you should know that the more processed a food is, the unhealthier it is. You might be surprised to know that white rice is a processed food, because the original version is actually, wait for it, brown rice. Yeah, this is why brown rice is healthier. So, between white rice and noodles, which are processed more? Usually, the easiest way to check is to determine how many ingredients there are. The key step in processing white rice is just to remove the outer husk, the brown and the jolly. So for rice, it has generally only one ingredient. For noodles, depending on the noodles, there are many ingredients which are mixed into a dora and cut into noodles. This is why earlier, I said that the calories for noodles can be rather broad, as different noodles, even if they are all yellow noodles, can have different ingredients. This means that rice is much less processed, so rice is healthier. So yes, as of now, based on just science, rice has 2 points and noodles have 3 points. It's net and net, so let's move on to the next stage, statistic. Like it or not, sales is the best feedback for anything. So even if you run a business and have a product with lots of positive feedback but bad sales, it's still a bad product. You just have very bad friends who prefer to hurt your business than your ego. Anyways, the best statistic, therefore, is to look at sales, which is the global market size. I know it might seem unfair, because noodles have many categories, like instant noodles, pasta, bee hoon or whatnot. I wanted to separate them, but I later realized that I didn't need to, because even when we talk about the entire noodles industry, you will still lose to the rice industry by a huge margin. You see, the global rice market is at about $287.45 billion a year, while the entire noodle industry, which even includes pasta, is only at $83.49 billion a year. Therefore, for the market size, rice wins hands down. But do people really eat more rice? Now, I tried to find the figures for global consumption, and while I do find the figures for rice consumption, I couldn't find any specific data for noodles, since there are so many different types of noodles. But given that on average, a whopping 6.815 trillion bowls of rice are consumed a year, and just under 117 billion servings of instant noodles are consumed a year, it's safe to say that rice is still consumed a lot more than noodles. Therefore, rice still wins here. Now, with science and statistics, rice now has 4 points and noodles have 3 points. We are still net and net, which brings us to the next point, survey in Singapore. Okay, I've got to admit, this is the weakest part of this comparison, given that the sample size is way too small as we have got too few viewers. So if you really want to help, please subscribe to us. You're a very poor thing. Do video, no one watch, do survey, no one take. Ayo. Anyways, basically, we did a survey on our YouTube channel community page asking people two questions. Which do you prefer, rice or noodles? And the second is, when you order yong tau hu or mala, do you choose rice or noodles? In the first question, 61% of you choose rice. But when asked again on what you would choose when you order yong tau hu or mala, a whopping 76% choose noodles instead. Therefore, I can only come to this conclusion. All my viewers are like that indecisive girlfriend who didn't know what to eat in Jurong Point. So, for this, rice gained 1 point while noodles gained 1 point. And therefore, here's the overall result. Rice has 5 points and noodles have 4 points. So having said that means we have a winner. Rice! But if you realize, it's so net and net. So I'll say that if possible, just don't eat these simple cups. I know, eat bread instead. Watch this video and you'll know why they're unhealthy. And thank you for spending almost 9 minutes with me. I really appreciate it and hope you learn something.